हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन माय यूट्यूब चैनल एडवोकेट अमित कुमार गुप्ता। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट केस। द नेम ऑफ द केस इज न्यू ट्रक ऑपरेटर्स यूनियन वर्सेस इनकम टैक्स ऑफिसर। दिस केस हैज बीन डिसाइडेड बाय चंडीगढ़ ITAT एंड द मैटर हैज बीन रिपोर्टेड इन 99 ITR एट पेज नंबर 522। द डेट ऑफ द जजमेंट इज 13 सितंबर 2022। The facts of the case are very interesting. In this case, the whole mistake of the assessee was that, or you can say that the lapse on the part of the assessee was that, the assessee was not able to produce the books of accounts and the vouchers before the assessing officer. The matter was related to the assessment year 13-14. The assessing officer made the addition by applying the net profit rate of 12% in the case of the assessee. The reasoning given by the assessing officer was that the assessee was not able to produce the original books of accounts and vouchers before him. That is why he is taking the net profit rate at 12%. The interesting fact in this case was that for the same assessee, in the succeeding assessment year, that is the assessment year 14-15, in the assessment of the assessee, the net profit ratio was taken at 5%. For net profit rate of 12%, which was applied by the assessing officer, the assessee went to the CIT appeal, that is the National Faceless Appeal Center. The appeal was decided by the National Faceless Appeal Center, and the National Faceless Appeal Center reduced the net profit rate of 12% to 5% by taking the base of the succeeding year, which has been taken by the assessing officer in the case of the assessee itself. The reasoning given by the National Faceless Appeal Center was that the rate of 5% has been taken in the case of the assessee for the succeeding year. So, the rate of 12% is exorbitant. So, the CIT appeal, that is the National Faceless Appeal Center in this case, restricted the net profit ratio at 5%. But there was no basis for 12% by the assessing officer also, and of taking the rate of 5% by the National Faceless Appeal Center. But the rate of 5% was based on the addition done by the assessing officer at 5% in the succeeding year. This was the only logic. When the matter came to the ITAT, ITAT said that the past history of the assessee has not been taken care of. And in this particular case, no reasoning has been given by the assessing officer and by the CIT appeal for adopting this 12% rate or 5% rate. But at the same time, ITAT said that there is also a lapse on the part of the assessee for the non-production of the books of accounts and vouchers. So, the assessee should not be left scot-free. So, the ITAT reduced the net profit ratio of 5% to 2.5%, saying that this taking the rate of 2.5% will do the ends of the justice, and the assessee will also be penalized for non-production of books of accounts and vouchers before the assessing authority. So the rate which was taken by the assessing officer at 12% was reduced to 5% by the National Faceless Appeal Center, and that rate was reduced by the ITAT to 2.5%. So, by the analysis of this case, we can say that the assessee gets the relief nowadays in the very slow process or in the partial process. But if the assessee will not go for this, then whatever the rate has been taken by the assessing officer will become the precedent, and the same rate will be applied for the other assessment years also. So once the matter is decided by the ITAT. So it becomes a question of fact, and so the winning of chances of the department in the High Court is also very very fake, or you can say very weak. So in these particular type of cases, the SSC has to fight his case, so that unnecessary adoption of ad hoc rates or ad hoc additions should not be adopted by the department. By fighting these type of cases, a little bit relief is given to the SSC in the due process of law, but it is a little bit lengthy process. So at the end of this video, once again I am repeating the name of the case. The name of the case is New Truck Operators Union versus Income Tax Officer. Thank you, friends.